Paul James and work with Paul James?
I've been knowing Paul ever since he was about 17, 18 years old. Somewhere like that, I believe. He was playing at the El Combo, and that was when he had a group called Lick and Stick, and he backed me up. And I knew then. See, he don't know it, but I still got some of the old tapes.
Oh, yeah.
That I recorded that night, because that was the first cassette recorder that I ever bought, and I bought it in Toronto on Yonge Street. And I recorded some of the songs on that we did. And the cat has come a long way. He was good then, but he is dynamite now.
Because I've been following Paul from those Lick and Stick days as well, since 1971, I think. And I was just anxious to see what or how you came about meeting. Because you worked on a movie at one point, too, with him.
Yeah. We did a soundtrack, which we got screwed out of. You know, some funny things went down with it. I never seen a dime, you know, which I saw the guy that produced it, which is N. Johnson or something from Toronto here, and he's living down in Alabama, and he claims he never got a dime, so therefore he couldn't give me a dime so that I could reach back and throw something on the band, you know. In fact, we all got messed around, but I did it in good faith, and I'm pretty sure N's part of it was in good faith. And but it just never worked out. It just didn't go the way that it was all planned out, you know. And we didn't fall out, we're still friends, and I love him, you know. He's a good dude. If I didn't, I wouldn't be bringing this record up here telling you how happy I am to see him with a new album. And I can almost say that I might be kind of responsible for him doing this, because he was undecided. I was up here 2 months ago, and I told him, I says, Paul, if you can't get a record company to do it for you, it ain't but 12 months in a year, 8 hours in a day, 7 days to a week. Get up off your buns and do it yourself. We live in a free society. That enables us to move ahead individually. Don't have to ask anybody any questions. And then I told him, ain't it good to be free?
Because you had your mail order company already set up at that time?
And he didn't understand exactly what I meant. I told him, I says, I got this tape called Ain't It Good to Be Free. And it means exactly what it says. It gives us the opportunity here in the United States and Canada to be our own man and stand up and make something of ourselves. Sometimes you can try for years and can't get nobody to turn around and look at you, you know. So you got the opportunity. Go do it yourself. The same people that press records for a record, big record companies, will press up you as many as you want, as long as you got the dollars.
That's the important part of it, I guess,
right.
The dollars.
Dollar bills.
Yeah.
And so what he had me when I walked in last night, I looked at him, I said, you did it. It's great, you know.
Yeah, I was talking to him on the phone the other day, I guess, and he was saying that they just ordered their second pressing.
Yeah. And I helped him on this. You know, one of the songs on here that I had the pleasure of writing.
How long ago did you do that? We're talking about The Ugliest Girl in Town.
Before. Yeah. yep.